Well, YouTube, thanks for your donations. Thanks to your donations, we got the better lighting, even though it's not the best lighting ever. I'm sure we're gonna be improving that, and audio and a better camera and overall look and feel of the videos. So in those videos, what I'm telling you is how to, and I'm telling you and I'm showing you how we take care of your problems here. If you're in the United States, you can send us the laptop. We're going to fix it up. No big deal. The prices are below. Or check out the website to make sure the prices are still the same. Majority of our viewers are outside of the United States because the world is a big. And so we are showing step by step how you can fix your laptop. This is a UX303U. Asus ZenBook UX303. U, and it uses 65 watt power supply. If you look closely into that Asus, you will see that you see there is no pin inside of that jack, nothing. My understanding, the pin was broken and was stuck inside of this plug, and they also, when they tried to remove the plug, the pin from the plug, they damaged the surroundings of the plug to the point where you can't really use that plug anymore. Because when you're gonna be putting this in, it's not gonna go as well, as perfectly fine in, because there should be plastic right here softening up the traction between the negative and the negative part of the jack. There should be a spring here, and the spring gonna be scratching right there, and it's eventually gonna break. So not only we have to replace the jack, but we also have to replace the plug. All right, so yeah, at the end of the video, if you'll find the video useful, please leave a like. But for right now, let's begin. This is a T5 Torx 5 screwdriver. Let's start unscrewing all the screws one by one. All right, so that's a long screw. Goes right there. By the way, you can send us the whole laptop, or you could send us just the motherboard. That's a small screw. So set it aside for the small screw. And if you send us just the motherboard, it's going to be cheaper. And I'm showing you how you can take everything apart without hiding anything from your point of view. So the best we can do is right here in terms of showing you, explaining you how you can take everything out without damaging anything. All right, so Torx 5. Now, you don't really have to have a Torx 5 screwdriver. Just regular tiny screwdriver gonna do the trick. But if you want, we got a link below that shows you. Oh, we don't have a flat screwdriver. I have it here someplace, but the video is gonna be long enough. So here we unscrew a few more screws. And yeah, like that. All right, like that, and like that, and so we got the screw right under this pad. Let's unpad this guy. We got another screw right there. That's not a Torx screw. This is a really long, two long screws that probably go below the hinge area. And now maybe there are two screws right there. Could be not, I don't know. But I'll just try to use the guitar pick, take the casing out. Here we see that somebody already disconnected the battery, which is the right thing to do. And there is the jack right there. The jack seems to be soldered just fine. In fact, it's a really good job. Mm-hmm. Okay. They removed the hard drive. And so the first thing we need to do is obviously disconnect the battery. If that's a laptop like yours, you just disconnect the battery right here by lifting up on both sides, just like that, and unscrew the battery. Right, this screw is really long screw right there, this one. So if you were looking for the tutorial on how to replace the battery on this laptop, this is pretty much it. That's how you replace the battery. Okay. All right. Now let's do a little bit more close up like that. So we got a cable right here. I got the cable right there. Remove that guy. Remove that one. And remove that one. All right, good job. Disconnect this wire right here. Let's set the screws aside. And now let's lift up that guy. I'm not sure if I should even. Yeah, I have to take the heatsink off. The reason I have to take the heatsink off because there is a screw under the heatsink right there. Now here we also have another screw for the fan. And here is the connection for the fan. Like that. And I got into some sort of glue in here, someplace. Alrighty. So we need to disconnect those screws right here. One and two. Right now we want to disconnect the LCD LED cable. And it's kind of taped to the motherboard, so we set it aside like that. And now we want to bend out the casing a little bit like that, so that the hinge will be bent out by itself. And now we can probably take the heatsink off. The heatsink comes off. The fan comes off as well. And here we have the through right there, through right there, and another screw right there. One more screw right here. All right, and one and two screws right here. Okay. So again, if you were looking on how to replace the battery, it's right there. How to replace the hard drive, it's right here. How to replace the motherboard on this laptop, this is tutorial good enough for you. And how to replace the jack, I'm gonna show you in a little bit. again, for those of you who are leaving us here, because you don't need to replace the jack, please leave a like. Feel free to subscribe. Here is much better view of missing pin. You see, there is no pin in there. What should be there is something like that. You see, this has a pin inside. So my goal is to desolder this guy, solder a new one in, put it all back together. Now, first thing I need to do is I need to insulate the area around the jack using the captain tape. And the captain tape will make sure that none of the nearby components will fly off the motherboard. Okay, so like that. Like that, like that. So now those components are not gonna get any heat on them once I'm gonna start desoldering. And I need to put some captain tape on the bottom. Link to this tape is available below. It's from Amazon. And the link to the Amazon is below, as well as pretty much all the other tools that we use are right there. So here, like that. And like that. So good job. Good job. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add some flux. I'm gonna add some leaded base solder. It's gonna mix with the old solder. And I'm gonna use some hot air and it's gonna drop the jack downwards. Then I'm gonna use some flux, put the new jack in and solder everything up. Let me show you how it's gonna be done. I'm adding some flux, which is frozen for right now. Doesn't want to squeeze out in any way. Come on. All right. I will warm it up in a second. Now I didn't power up the hot air station yet. That's powered up now. On really small and now I'm gonna use the soldering wick to desolder the remaining solder from the traces. You see? Piece of cake. Let's clean up the top side as well. All right. Okay.
So now I'm gonna add some flux to the top side. Right, so flux on the top side. And we're gonna put the jack in. All right, make sure it's nice and straight. And let's add some flux on the bottom side. All right. All right. Good job. Again, I'm just making sure it's all nice and straight in. Like that. Like that. And like that. Like that. Good job. All right, so upon further inspection, I saw that everything is extremely beautifully soldered. Again, if the video was useful, consider leaving a like, at least you can do. If we can improve the video in any way, shape, or form, let us know. All right. I'm just cleaning up the motherboard from the flux. Alrighty. And let's do one more time. Beautiful. Do you see how beautiful it is? Amazing. You know what, let me just solder this guy as well. Wonderful. Good job. Excellent. So here. Clean this guy up, clean all of that stuff. In the other side. All right, and now I'm just gonna let it dry for a few minutes. Okay. All right, so this is the final product right there. Right there. You see, just like factory work, and I just wanna make sure that there is no shortage. Minus, minus. That doesn't show like a minus. And that doesn't conduct anything. So I guess minus, 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 minus. And a plus right here is some resistance. Okay. What I will need to do is I will need to modify the plug as well. Let's put it all back together. Like that, like that, like that. Okay, so we need to put this cable through right here. Okay. We pull this through. Lower it down. Everything should just drop into place perfectly. Okay. All right, and the hole inside right here is supposed to align with the jack. Let me show you. You see, that's that black piece is sitting inside of that hole. Now, let's try and pull this guy right there. This guy, let's connect right here. Close that. And let's close this guy. Okay. Let's try and close that guy. Let's connect that keyboard cable right there into the motherboard like that. That's the gluey. Lots of glue here for some reason, not sure where it came from. But I guess like that. And let's try and remove this glue altogether. Okay. Now here this thing goes in like that. And it drops in like that. Okay. Here. This piece goes here. That piece goes there. And this guy goes right there. Good job. Okay. So let's solder, let's screw down that one right there. Okay. And let's screw down the one right here. Okay. And now is a good time to put the fan in and connect the fan right there. Okay. And now we're gonna close down the hinge. Don't penetrate your finger when you're closing down the hinge, because there are two spikes that are pretty nice and hard in there, and you can mess up your fingers pretty badly. Here, right there. That's a long black screw right there. And that's another long black screw right here. Tighten it all down. Right, and we got another screw going in. Right. Here was the screw from the hard drive. Right. And or was that the one from, maybe that was, that one right here is from a much longer screw right here. Yeah. Okay. Here, this is a longer screw. Right, and we got one more longer screw right there. Now don't forget those two screws right here, one and two, silver. Not that long screws, like right there, medium, short length, I would say. Like that. And one like that. Okay. Now we wanna screw in this guy right here. Right there. And let's screw down the long screw, the longest screw goes right here, and the remaining four screws go all over the perimeter right here. One and two. And three. And four. All right. Now don't connect the battery yet. Here, I'll remove all the stickers because they're not necessary here. Now the reason why I didn't put the heatsink on, because I need to clean the CPU and I need to clean the heatsink, and then I need to put a thermal paste onto both sides. So here should be thermal paste, and then it's going to penetrate and flow all over the heatsink as well. But for right now, I just need to make sure that everything is screwed in together and no screws are missing. Okay. But that's pretty much it. So screw here for the hard drives. This is all pressed in. That's connected. This is connected. I just don't like to take the laptop apart the second time around. And yeah, let me clean up the heatsink over the garbage can, because it's a lot of silicone that's gonna be flying all over the place. Alrighty, so I did clean up the heatsink. Nice and shiny. Here we got the thermal paste, which is also frozen. Yeah. Let's see if it's gonna squeeze out. Yep, it does squeeze out like that. Make sure it's all over. You know what, I don't like the consistency of that paste. Let me get it off the motherboard. Okay. Let's try one more time. Okay. Alright. And okay. And alright. Now let's squeeze it out a little bit and close it down like that. Okay. Now we put the heatsink back on, and we got four screws right here, four silver screws, which we're gonna screw right there and right there and right here. Okay. All right. And okay, last but not least, you want to connect the battery. Okay, the battery seems all right. Maybe it's an aftermarket battery, I'm not sure, but it's not fluffy or anything like that. So let's just one last final peek into everything what's going on here. We'll cover it down like that and make sure. Okay. So something isn't right. Something isn't right. Something isn't right. Okay, so like that. Now everything's alright. Alright. Good. Alrighty, guys, honestly, press a like button. It will help out tremendously. I'm going out of my way to do every single step there is without hiding anything. from anybody. So here we got a silver long screw going in there. And another silver screw going in right there. And this guy's supposed to go in there. And this guy's supposed to go right there. Okay. Now we're gonna put the sticker right there. And put the, another pad right there. And we got a whole bunch of little tiny screws, which we're gonna screw in right here. Screw in right there. And right there. And right there. Maybe I should change a background of some sort here, so that the lighting, the lights will be more. Even though I have plenty of lights here, it's just the camera dims down everything significantly. That's my take. Alright. Alrighty. And everything's gonna be alright. And we flip it over. So Asus laptop. Let's try this plug first. And then maybe I'm just gonna chop off the cord and put another cord on this. But not to waste your time showing you how to chop off the cord and put another cord. I'm just show you that everything should work. Now, you know what first thing I want to do is double check that the current goes through the motherboard, through the plug. So we're just gonna put this guy in there. And let's see. All right, so we got 20 volts coming out. Good job. Alrighty, let's put this thing right. You see, that's what I was talking about. It doesn't want to come in. Doesn't want to go into the new jack because it grabs onto the metal. All right, so now it's in. We got some sort of white light right there, meaning that the batteries might be charged. I'm not sure. Let's see if this is all nice and comfy. All right, so wow, it's an i7. That's the reason why it's still in business. Okay. So it came up by itself. Asus in search of incredible. Still searching for incredible. And today is 11:30, 2020, and this is 7. Oh, this is 19. It's 19, 15. All right, so we're gonna press 7 exit. Exit. 6th generation Intel processor. All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave a like. Oh yeah, by the way, there's no hard drive. And you guys stay safe. Thank you.